Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Civil Learning. And today in this video I am going to discuss about the design of purlin. As exam point of view, design of purlin is very important, and here are some quick steps, or we can say that easy steps, through which you students will be easily learn how to design the purlin. So I have pick out some steps, and I am going to design the purlin according to these steps which you are currently watching in this video. So without wasting time, let's begin the video. For making the learning more efficient, it would be better to copy the question and then read it and try to understand, and then follow the step which is being shown in the video. So the question which I have selected for the designing of purlin was asked in 2019 December PTU examination. So further I am going to continue the video. So here comes step one. In step one, we are going to classify the loads. The loads may be due to dead load or due to live load. Dead load may be snow load or load of the seating, as in the question there is the weight of corrugated seating, and we are going to classify the first find the load, that how much load is acting per unit length or between the spacing of the purlin, or per unit area we can say. See, in the question there was load due to corrugated seating 130, so I have multiplied it with 1.5, and here 1.5 is spacing of the purlin. As you can see in the question, we are given as spacing of purlin is 1.5, so I have multiplied it with 1.5, and I have taken the depth as 1 meter, okay, and this is our weight due to seating, and load due to live load. What is due to and load or due to live load will be, we are given here 0.6 kilonewton per meter square. So I have converted it into newton per meter square by multiplying it with 10.10 to the power 3, and yes, spacing between the, again it is multiplied with the spacing between the purlin, which is 1.5, so 1.5, and again depth 1, so it will be 900 newton per meter, and I have considered self weight of the purlin as 100 newton per meter. You can consider it between the range of 100 to 125 newton per meter. So I have considered it as 100 newton per meter. Now the I have calculated the factor dead load plus live load. It is actually dead load plus live load plus self weight. See, factor, I have taken factor 1.5, and all the loads are added, and then our load becomes 1.79 kilonewton per meter. Okay, now this load is resolved in vertical and horizontal direction. See, this W cos theta is the load which is acting normal to the seating. See, if we consider that this is seating, then this load is normal to the seating. This load is taken as normal to the seating, and one thing more, wind load is always considered as normal to the seating. And further, when we resolve this into horizontal and vertical direction, then this load is taken as W sin theta is taken as parallel to the seating, and W cos theta is taken as normal to the seating. Now the component of load, this load, component of this load is in normal to the seating will be W cos theta, so I have calculated its value. Now the second one is component of load parallel to the seating, then it will be W sin theta, W sin theta, so I have calculated its value. Now I am given wind load. Here in the question I am also given wind load, and as I showed you that wind load is acting always normal to the seating, so factored wind load, first I have calculated factored wind load. Factored wind load will be, this is our factor, and load is 1.8 newton per kilonewton per meter square. So I haven't converted into newton per meter square, I have just taken is kilonewton per meter square, and our area will be 1.5 into 1, so our load becomes this much. Now here comes no load normal to the seating. No load normal to the seating means total load with component of load acting in normal direction and normal to the seating, and another load due to wind load. Here the total is this 5.6 kilonewton per meter, and the load parallel to the seating will be 0.89 kilonewton per meter. We have calculated it previously. Now the second step is to determine the moment. Now I am going to determine the moment. Mzz means moment in zz direction will be WL square by 8 simply, and here WL square by 8. So I have calculated the moment. Zz direction means normal to the seating is z, and parallel to the seating is y. Okay, and this is the thing I have calculated this. Okay, now the second step comes, calculate zpz required, means how much we need to find the zpz. So for that we adopt b is equal to 75 millimeter and d is equal to 150 millimeter. It is done, it should be adopted such that d is actually twice of b, means depth is actually twice of width. Now for finding the form zpz required, we have a formula. This is the formula which is not mentioned in the code. You have to remember this formula. It is simple. See, this and this are common, but only the difference is mzz and myy, and here the extra number terms are 2.5 d by b. okay, simply this is 150 by p 75, which is actually 2 times. Okay, now zpz required is this much. Now I have in the question I was given to, I was told to design I section purlin, so I section purlin, so I am going, I have used my code, page number, let me check it, it's page number is from where you are going to find the value of z, it is in page number 139. Selection is done on the basis of zpz required. We have to take a value little greater than this, so I have selected this Indian standard heavy beam 150 at 300.2, and I have copied all this value zpz. The actual zpz value of this section is this much, so I have taken all the value. Now here comes our step 4. In step 4 we have to classify the section as this in IS code 800 2007. It is in page number 18, where epsilon is equal to 250 by fy. So I have calculated value 1. Now I have calculated b by df. Here while calculation or classification of the section, b is equal to this b width of the flange divided by twice 150 is divided by 2. Then here comes 75 divided by thickness of flange. Here comes 7.97, which is less than 9.4e according to code. Then and d by tw. Here d is calculated by using formula d is equal to h1 plus 2 times r1, and value of this number can be calculated from the steel table book sp6. Okay, and I have calculated this value, and it comes it should be less than 84b for the section to be plastic. As it is less, so the section is plastic. Now the next step is to find mdz. For mdz we have a formula zpz fy by gamma mo. It is available in code in page number 53, mdz. And the second next step is to find mdy. Just the difference is zpz and zpy. For zpy we have formula zpy is equal to zyy into shape factor. Zyy is taken from the table, and shape factor is taken from table last page, from where you got previous values. Shape factor is available where from where you select the section, and zyy is given in steel book handbook. Okay, and I have calculated zpy, and I put that value in this here, and I got the value mdz and mdy. Now mdy is less than myy, hence the section is okay. Now we have to apply final checks, and final checks consist of two checks. First, this is check for the purlin, mzz by mdy plus myy by mdy is less than 1. It's as it is true, hence our section is right. Now Let's say one more check we need to apply is check for the deflection. Then check for the deflection implies the maximum permissible deflection. Maximum permissible deflection is spanned by 180. It is in table 6 of code. This we have to take brittle cladding. Okay, this is maximum deflection, and for the deflection due to load we have formula 5 by 384 w l to the power 4 by e. I have calculated its value as it is less than 384, hence our section is safe, and hence we can provide this purlin, which is safe, and it is as per the design. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you would have been able to design the purlin after watching this video. Further, I will be adding more videos related to other engineering subjects, and thanks for again, and keep supporting my channel. Thank you. Do like, share, comment.